Hi friends, welcome to TechnoStube. In this video, we are discussing previous year questions of tradesman's welding examination. We can expect these questions for the upcoming junior instructor welder examination. Okay, let's begin start. Which one of the process prefers bare metal electrode and granular flux? In submerged arc welding, bare metal electrodes and granular flux are used. Spot welding, seam welding, flash butt welding is different methods of. These welding methods, spot welding, seam welding, flash butt welding are the under category of resistance welding. Which type of electrode is used in submerged arc welding? In the first question itself, the answer is there. Bare metal electrode, that is bare wire electrode. In which position submerged arc welding is done? Answer is flat and horizontal. Which one of the following is a resistance welding process? Out of this, spot welding is the resistance welding process. Okay. The second question itself, the answer is there. Shielded metal arc welding is classified under the process of. Shielded metal arc welding. In the name itself is there arc welding. It's a type of arc welding, that is, answer is electric arc welding. Punches used for marking purpose are made of. Punches for marking purpose are made of high carbon steel. A ball pin hammer is specified by. Ball pin hammer is specified by its weight. The tool used to draw lines on chalk coated metal surface is called. Scriber. It is a resistance welding process in which roller type electrodes are used. Seam welding, seam resistance welding process. The electrodes are made of rollers. Which of the following metal plates cannot be joined by the projection welding? Answer is copper plates. Because in projection welding or resistance welding are the applications of electrical resistance. If we are using copper plate as the working material or welding material, it's having high thermal conductivity and electrical conductivity also. The resistance between this plate is very negligible and there is no heat generation between the plates also will happen. That's why we can weld copper plates with the projection welding method. What is the purpose of copper coating on mild steel filler wire? Because to avoiding rusting. Which mechanical properties of metals have resistance to pulling force? Resistance to pulling force. Pulling force means tensile force. Resistance to tensile force means tensile strength. Tensile strength is the right answer. In this question, some confusion will happen. Ductility. Ductility is the property which permit a material to be drawn out longitudinally to irreducible sections under the action of tensile force. That is the ductility. Toughness, but toughness is the property of material which enable to absorb energy without fracture. That is toughness. But hardness, it is the ability of the material to resist indentation or surface abrasion. That is hardness. The resistance to pulling force is tensile strength. A keyhole is to be maintained throughout in the first run of the butt joint to ensure. To ensure proper root penetration. Which of the following metal has highest thermal conductivity? Highest thermal conductivity. For this, highest thermal conductivity is copper. Overheating of blowpipe nozzle to be avoided because it will cause flashback. Oxygen gas will change into liquid condition the melting point of oxygen. The melting point of oxygen is -182.9 degrees Celsius. Which of the following metal has highest melting temperature? Highest melting temperature is tungsten material. In which position is electro slag welding generally done? Answer is vertical position. One of the advantages of submerged arc welding: high deposition rate and speed, quality of the weld, thick metal can be welded. These all are the main advantages of submerged arc welding. Which of the following are ferromagnetic material? Ferromagnetic materials. In this question, two answers will happen: iron, cobalt, nickel, or copper, aluminum, silver. In the solvent removal penetrant process, excess penetrant is removed with the solvent removal penetrant method, penetrant process. This process is related to liquid penetrant test. That is a type of non-destructive testing process. This process used in for welding. This process is using for identifying the crack on the weld bead. The excess penetrant is removed with the clean, lint-free towel, slightly moistened with the solvent. That is the process. The limitations of liquid penetrant test is: Out of this, the limitations for the liquid penetrant test is porous materials. Porous materials cannot be tested. This liquid penetrant test cannot be done on porous materials. Porous materials. Gas welding tip orifice should only be cleaned with gas welding tip orifice is cleaned with a tip cleaner. Thank you.